to the nearest emergency exit. Thank you for your cooperation, and we hope you enjoy the show.
Yeah. Now, of course, if someone special Look to come along.
Well, exactly. Madam Horrible, we haven't received our own assignment.
The government is concerned for your sister's well-being quite apparent. She will share my compartment where I can assist her as needed.
No, but I've always looked after my sister.
He never mentioned you. Slight gulch, not to fret. We'll find some place to put you.
No, but madam, I don't think she even read my essay.
That's so unfair. You should say something.
Should I?
Oh, attention, attention. Which of you young ladies will volunteer to share with Miss Elphaba? Why, thank you, my dear.
That is very good of you.
Why?
You see, Miss Elphaba, you can room with Miss Glinda.
Something just comes over me sometimes, something I can't describe, but I will try to control.
Token goat, as it were. But it wasn't always this way. Oh, dear, so looks. How how I wish you could have known this place as it once was, when one would walk these halls and hear an antelope explicating a sonnet, a snow leopard solving an equation, a wildebeest waxing philosophic. Can you see, students, what's being lost? Our dear Oz is becoming less and less, well, colorful. Now, what set this into motion?
From what I read, it began with the great drought.
Precisely. Food grew scarce, and people grew hungrier and angrier, and the question became, whom can we blame? Can anyone tell me what is meant by the term scapegoat? Someone besides myself. Oh, yes, Miss Glinda.
It's Galinda with a gall. And I don't see why you can't just teach us history instead of always harping on the past.
Well, perhaps these questions that I have prepared will change.
Should be seen and not heard.
Yes, Elphaba, don't worry about me. Go and join your friends.
Oh, that's all right. I have no friends. Would you like to share my lunch?
Oh, thank you. How kind.
Ignorant statements like that bother you. I mean, I always do, but you shouldn't.
Oh, Miss Elphaba. If only it were just a matter of words on a chalkboard. But the things one hears these days. Dreadful things. I've heard of a box, a professor of box, no longer permitted to teach, who has lost all powers of speech. A vicar with a thriving flock forbidden to preach. That only can stretch. Only rumour, but still enough to give pause to anyone with pause. Something bad is happening in Oz.
Something bad happening in Oz.
Under the surface, behind the scenes, something bad.
Someone's got to tell the wizard. He'll make advice. That's why we have a wizard. So nothing bad.
I will be advised. Nothing all bad.
through life, nearly knocking people over and not even noticing them.
Maybe the driver saw green and thought it meant go.
Mr. Linda, I know I'm just a mere munchkin. But even a munchkin has feelings, and I tried to tell you of mine for you, but sometimes it's like you don't even know who I am.
Oh, that's not true, Vic.
But
Vic, do you realize who that is?
You're touching me!
That is Fiero Tigalar. He is that winky prince whose reputation is so scandalous. Were you looking for something, or...?
Someone.
Oh, yes. Some sort of history class.
Well, that's the history building there.
But the class just ended.
Perfect timing. So, this will be your first fun around here.
Nothing. Until now.
We've been studying!
Well, I see that once again the responsibility to corrupt my fellow students falls to me. The trouble with schools is they always try to teach the wrong lesson. Believe me, I've been kicked out of them to know. They want you to become less callow, less shallow. But I say, why am I stressed? And stop studying strife. And learn to live the unexamined life.
I don't know what you mean.
Oh, please.
What is it? going to be married.
He's asked you already?
Oh, he doesn't know yet.
You got an awfully long
And now, for the finishing touch.
Animals are no longer permitted to teach.
What?
Please, yourself. I want to thank you all for sharing with me your enthusiasm, your essays, however feeble its structure, and even on occasion, your lunch.
Oh, Doctor! I'm so terribly sorry.
No, you can't permit this.
Miss Elphaba, don't worry about me. They can take away my job. But I shall continue speaking out. Come on, go. You're not being told the whole story! Remember that door!
Dr. Dillon! Well, are we all just going to sit here in silence?
Miss Elphaba, I'm afraid there's nothing we can do.
No, but madam!
Please, my dear, take your seat.
Good afternoon, students.
Good afternoon.
More and more every day, please think of the time dragon clock in every corner of our great hall. One hears the silence of progress. For example, this is called a cave. And we'll be seeing more and more of them in the future. This remarkable innovation is actually for the animal's own good.
It's so good for him. Why is he trembling?
He's excited to be here. That's all. Now, as I was saying, one of the benefits of caging a lion of this young is that he will never, in fact, learn how to speak.
Oh no, that's right.
Gather round.
Can you imagine a world where animals are kept in cages? And they never speak?
Oh, he doesn't seem a bit agitated. But that is easily remedied.
What am I going to do?
We?
Well, somebody has to do something!
Mouth shut, is that what you're saying?
Oh,
you think I want to be this way? You think I want to carry the gun? Does it matter how many no matter how shallow and self-absorbed you pretend to be.
Excuse me, there's no pretense here. I happen to be genuinely self-absorbed and deeply shallow.
No, you're not. You wouldn't be so unhappy. No, I do. My heart is pounding. I didn't mean to hurt you.
What did you mean to do? And why was I the only one you didn't do it to?
You're bleeding.
I am.
It must have scratched you.
Yeah. Or maybe it scratched me or something. Well, I better hide it to say be coming to come.
Whoever is
one is for you.
No, he's the one.
That's not right. Don't worry about me, Elphaba. I'll be fine.
Safe journey. No.
Nessa, wait.
Elphaba, no. Let her go. She'll have to manage without you.
We all will. You'll barely notice I'm gone. You have Piero.
Where is he anyway?
Not that I expected him to say goodbye to me. We barely know each other.
I don't know him either. Not anymore. He is distant and moodified, and he's been thinking, which really worries me.
I've been thinking.
Yes, I heard.